Hello everyone. I had to do a little prelude on this video. This video here has taken almost 3 months to film. And you're going to see a couple of times it's going to get kind of choppy because this video would have been an hour and a half long if I would have used all the footage. I do explain that in the video though, so you'll see that. Also in this video, if I refer to last time, if this is the first video you've watched on the Incubating Minnesota Chicken Coop series, there is a previous video when I hatched the first one. So anyway, thought I would get that out of the way so that everybody knows before you start watching the movie. And I'll see you at the end. Hello everyone, and welcome back once again to the chicken coop here in Minnesota. This time around in the incubators, right now I have goose eggs, turkey eggs, and duck eggs in this one. They take 28 days to hatch. It's been in there for 5 days, so now we're down to 23 days, and I have some quail eggs up that you just saw up at the table right here, and these are Butler bobwhite quail. They're a really big bobwhite. They say they can get up to twice as big as a regular bobwhite, so I have to put these in today so that everything locks down at the same time. So I'm going to put these in now, and then that's 23 days, and then in 2 more days I'm going to fill all the rest of the openings in there with chicken eggs, which take 21 days. You can see how big these goose eggs are. They're huge. I actually have 3 more of those coming, and they're going to go into this incubator over here. And in this one here I also have another, I think it's 5 or 6 dozen quail eggs coming, and then I'm also going to put chicken eggs in that one also. Okay, so that was 32 eggs that went in there, and now the temperature will go back up to 100, and that humidity will rise up. We'll be back in a couple days and add some chicken eggs. Well everyone, we're back again here. We are well into the incubating period right now. These right here, turkeys, geese, ducks, chickens, and quail, the Butler quail, are just 10 days away now from lockdown, and then 3 days after that we should start hatching eggs. I have a little over 3 dozen quail eggs right there. Those are snowflake. I've got the goose eggs right there. I've got my chicken eggs in. But today I decided to film because the first batches that I hatched, of the chickens anyway, are going into their new pen. I've been working the last couple weeks after work and stuff like that, making these new cages. This is roughly 10 feet deep, a little over 24 feet wide. I've got actually three different ones on this square part on this side. And then over on this end, I've got this one more that's not quite complete. I'll probably get this finished in the next couple days. This is just for the quail. Going to be a double decker back there so they can go up and down wherever they want to. It's a little bit bigger because I expect to have a lot of quail in here, and they like to fly around some. So, but for right now, I still have my little quail that I hatched before in the brooder with just a small light on them. Now I have 2 snowflake in there and the 4 bobwhite. Over here I had all the chickens in this side of my brooder that I just converted the rabbit cage into a brooder. They are now right here and ready to go into the cage. With this cage set up over here, I've got a 4x10. Here I've got a 4x10. This one is an 8x10. I'm going to put these in here right now because I have no reason to separate anybody out. So I just got this here. The back part is about 4x10. Got the roost, which they will not be able to jump up to yet, but they will eventually. See if they like it. I chose today to put them in here. I mean, they were definitely were big enough, but today it's, I don't know, it got up to about 88 degrees. It's probably 85 right now, so at least it's warm and they can slowly get into the nights, get down to, you know, 60 or so. So give them a chance to adapt. I got to go put their water and food in here, put that out here, and they'll be back there, and eventually they'll be jumping all over the place. The first brave ones are checking it out. Okay, well, today is the day that we're gonna lock down that first incubator inside. We're gonna go in there and do that in a minute. Here you can see those birds you saw just a couple clips ago. They're all getting bigger, and they've all been doing real well in here. And I did, I finished out this cage now, and the quail that you last saw in the brooder are now in here. So like I said, now we'll go inside and put those on lockdown. Got a couple of geese here for my daughter Sarah. And now all these are on the Jones Act Survival Channel and part of the Hobby Farm series. So anyway, let's go inside. Alright, so first thing we'll do is candle all these like we did before. Okay, we'll start with the duck eggs. That one looks good. That one is pretty clear. That one does not make it. Now we're going through the turkey eggs. I've candled these before. I think there's only two of these that are any good. Clear. That one, that looks good. Oh, these dark chicken ones are so hard. I mean, I can see that there's a air sac, but I can't see good enough to see if it's clear or not, so. Okay, so we have that many that I know did not make it, and you can kind of see over there, we'll look at them again, but since I'm going to be putting the quail in now, I want to put the separator in again, like I did last time, just to keep the chickens and ducks and whatever from completely squishing the quail. It's hard to say, I don't even know if you can see that. It's got a dark ring, but it is clear on the bottom, I'm not sure, I'll have to keep that one. That one is all clear, no good. So these are the ones that did not make it for sure. And these are the ones that are, you know, possibilities anyway. So I did better this time on the quail eggs. I think these are the butler bobwhite, which are supposed to be really big ones. And I have 2/3 of these are good. And I guess over here I'm still most excited about the two turkeys. It'll be neat to do the ducks. Chickens, I've got lots of chickens, so they're fun too. I really want to see what these darker ones look like. Maybe this time I'll be able to watch one of them hatch. Well, we'll bring that back up to temperature. I'm going to try to keep the humidity higher this time than I did last time. I don't want it to, it's going to get real high right now for a little bit until it evens out. But last time I think a lot of them that kind of shrink wrapped inside the shell was because I had it too dry in there. I just want to take a quick peek at these. These have 7 days until they go on lockdown. It looks like all of the goose eggs are clear in this one too, so I just had a bad batch of goose eggs. Well, I'll see you guys in just a few days. Like I said, 3 days and Even that's iffy when you got that many different kind of eggs. So anyway, these are on lockdown and we should be getting some chicks pretty quick. Well, everyone, I have some birds that have hatched in there and I'd like to keep them in a little bit longer, but there are a couple, I think one of them might be dead, that is kind of stuck in the shell, so I need to get into the incubator and try to take care of those. So I'm going to be adding some here to my little brooder. So this one right here has 4 or 5 quail that have hatched, 1 duck, and I think it's a couple of chickens. So we're going to get these all out of here and see what we have. Okay, so we have 1 chicken and this one is still alive. This one's been like this for 2 days now. And this one here is a turkey that's trying to hatch out, and it's still moving too, so I need to get these out of the shell. Okay, so now I'm going to put this one back in the incubator and hopefully it'll dry out and make it. Now for Mr. Turkey. So we've got 5 of the, these are the butler quail. That one might, we'll have to see what happens with that one. Sometimes I have to cull some of them because they can't walk good, but it takes a few hours before they really get their feet. And over here we have the 2 chickens and the 1 duck. I put this incubator on lockdown today. None of those goose eggs that I got from Louisiana were any good. They were all both batches, I didn't get anything, but this is how many eggs I have that are good. Every one of my chicken eggs candled okay. Of the snowflake quail, there was only 10 out of 39 that I had total that were not good. So, and the cartoonics or whatever they're called, I couldn't really candle those that good. I did talk to the Peg, the lady that I bought it from, Peggy, and she said they're super easy to candle because if they're not good, they light up like a light bulb. Well, the 2 that I looked at, I couldn't see anything, so she figures that those were good. I might take a look at them in another day, but really for right now, these are just on lockdown and I'll see what hatches. Over in this incubator, the one that has been on lockdown, that's hatching chicks. I haven't looked at it for about an hour. I do have the 2 little quail. They're gonna go into the brooder tonight. And as far as the rest of the chicken and the duck, and the turkey egg that was good, I don't think any of that's gonna hatch. It's just been too many days. But I did have a couple quail pop out, so you just never know. Tonight I'm gonna shut down the 1 incubator. All the hatching is done in that one. Ended up with quite a few little quail. That turned out pretty good. Still, like you saw before, only the 2 chickens and the 1 duck. I know you guys watched me pull those 2 birds, the turkey and the chicken, out of their shells last time, or just not too long ago. Both of them died. The turkey died on its own, and the chicken, I had to take care of that one myself. It just wasn't quite right. So out of what I had here, that many quail didn't hatch. I'm real surprised on my chickens. They did have to sit for a long time though, before I got them in here, trying to get all of the times right. And you know, I'm getting eggs every day, but my ducks, they only got the 1, so that was kind of sad. And my turkey, that 1 that was good, I was really hoping to get a couple of turkeys out of this and I didn't this time, so that's kind of sad. But we still have another incubator going right now. Those are going to go into the garbage can. Over on this incubator, yesterday I candled all the eggs and I locked this one down. As soon as the new chicks start hatching, these are going to go outside to that brooder that I built that's out in the rabbit barn. And these ones will too. This is going to be a long video, but I'll see you guys in a couple of days. Hey everyone, the hatch on incubator number 2 has begun. I just come out here and there was some chirping and it's halfway out of the shell, trying to get out of the rest of it. Okay guys, well today after work here we have a couple of chickens that have hatched. And there's, I don't know, 3 or 4 maybe of the cortunics or whatever they're called, quail. So I need to clean out or get the birds that are in the brooder over here right now in the box brought outside to the outside brooders, because I'm going to want to put the little ones in here and I'm going to get these guys out there too. And that duck, I cannot believe how wet and messy they are. And this is on plastic in here, but it's still in the house, so they've got to go out. So I just got these scraped out now, and I'm going to just separate these in half this time. Like you've seen these before, I can put them into 4 separate or 1 big. I'm going to do that because I anticipate quite a few quail hatching, and I'm not sure about how many chickens. I can always switch it around. So I'm the one that I'm going to put the chickens and the duck in, I'm going to put newspaper down. It makes it a lot easier to clean when the time comes, but in the quail pen, you can't do that. They can't be on a slippery surface, because I don't know if I talked about that in a clip earlier than this one here, but their feet go out and it pops a tendon in there. I've got one in there now that has not recovered from that. I had newspaper in there and I had to switch it out into paper towels, because then it's something they can grip onto. And that leg has not came back, so I'm pretty sure I'm going to have to cull that one out of the flock. And the last time I did that, I had the same thing happen and had to get rid of a couple of them. I didn't even know what was going on, but now I know. Okay. I think I might move this light to the inside. I mean, that's a 250-watt heat bulb. But last time, I don't know, quail really do need a lot of heat, and this is open enough now so they can escape from it if it's too warm. There, I think that'll be good. Kind of put some of the heat out, a little bit in. I just don't want to lose any like last time. Okay, let's go get the birds and put them out there. I think I'll take and put the chickens and the duck in with the quail for the trip out. I'm afraid it's the end of the road for this one. There's just no reason to wait. Well, there, I got a feeder in there for the chickens and the duck. And I put a bigger waterer, but I put rocks in there because that duck just likes to flail the water all over the place. So hopefully that might cut down on some of it. I doubt it. He's pretty good at it, but it's worth a try. There we go. We got the feeder in there and the waterer. And they're still scared to death, so I'm going to leave here for an hour and a half, 2 hours, and just let them kind of acclimate in here and see how they like it. All right, now I got these two all cleaned out and ready to go. Fresh water, fresh food. It's always good to throw a little food on the ground too. It's the first place they'll look because they're going to be scared when they come out of the incubator and are thrown into a box. I just quickly opened up the incubator and I pulled these four quail out. And these two chickens. I had to help another chicken out and another quail out of the eggs. And there in the incubator is drying right now. Okay everyone, well it's the next evening. Still have all these guys in here, but we have had a lot hatching in the incubator, and right now I'm gonna go in there, pull everything out that's alive, get them into the boxes here, the little brooder inside, and see what we got. I've tried looking in here with the flashlight through the little holes up here, but you really can't see what's going on. I know I had one snowflake that hatched, which was so exciting because I love those little quail. And there's several others in there, but anyway, I'm going to open it up now and we're going to pull them out. Those two right there are snowflake. It's time for me to take these chickens out to the outside brooder. It's time. I think they're done hatching now. I just opened up one egg in there that I did not realize had a pip in it. I don't know if that one will make it, but these have been in here for a few days now, so I'm going to bring these out. And now I've been hatching a bunch of the snowflake quail. I think I've hatched 10 here so far, so I'm going to take the Quaternix quail out to the outside brooder because they're bigger and they're bowled those little ones over like nothing, and then I'll just leave the snowflake in here. I actually have one snowflake that's in the incubator right now that's drying. Okay everyone, well I just shut this incubator down. She's done. These ones are not going to hatch. There was a couple that were pipped that I opened up and what was inside was dead. So it's been well past the amount of days now, so I'm going to get this cleaned out. And honestly, the incubator stinks. So I'm going to get this cleaned out. In a couple days we'll go through and look at everything that we got. Got those all cleaned out and washed with bleach. Okay everyone, well it's definitely time to wrap this video up. I've been doing this video for over 2 months now, and I apologize if there's anything that has overlapped and stuff like that. I'm going to show you the cages out there and what's been going on, and I'm really not sure what I have filmed and what I haven't filmed. So these are the bobwhites and the Quaternix or whatever they're called in here. They're getting big enough. I actually put one of them out in with the bigger quail. but they were brutal and attacked them. So I just got back from Louisiana, so it's been another week that these have grown. So later this week, I'm gonna put them out in with the big ones. These here are my snowflakes, the ones that have survived, the ones that hatched. I've had to cull a few of them because of some leg problems, which are quite common when you hatch these out. I might have said that already before, but these guys are doing good. So this part I'm not real sure what. I know you have seen the cages. I'm just not sure if you saw that I added on to it for the geese. And you guys saw we had bought two geese and then liked them so much, and they grow so fast. And since you can't tell what's a male and a female really, I went up and got two more so we can for sure get eggs in the spring. Nice looking birds. This here are those latest chickens that hatched, and this, well, the ones that hatched in this batch. And the ducks, one of them I hatched, the other two I bought. They grew kind of slow as far as getting feathers and stuff, but now they're growing really fast. In fact, later this week I'm going to put the ducks in with the geese. I want to put these little chickens in with the next chickens you're going to see, and then take the turkeys and put them over here in their own cage. So here we have the first hatch of them, the chickens and stuff. They're getting big. I've got three or four that try to crow in the morning for the roosters, turkeys, and they're starting to get bigger. I can't wait for those to get big, to be honest. These, some of them, are just a few weeks away from the frying pan. And here's the older, bigger quail. Those two snowflakes are just so beautiful, but I think they're both males, so I'm glad I got all the other ones so I can get some females mixed in with them. Okay, everyone. Well, thanks a lot for watching. I think if you're interested in incubating, hatching, and raising your own birds, if you haven't learned it here in the video series that Melissa and I have put up, the chicken coop, I don't know what else you really need to know. I mean, there have been good things. There's been, you've got to see the stuff that happens in the egg. Some of it's not all that pretty. Some of it's awesome. So anyway, I will see you guys on the next video. All right, everyone. I know that I was going to end this video, and that was weeks ago, but I want to bring this completely full circle. I'm going to put these out in the big cage now with all the other ones. They're big enough now, and at least you get to see everything from start to finish. I'm going to go ahead and put them in with these ones right now. It was brutal. They and the little ones got the crap beat out of them by the six that were in here, but now they all get along real good. This guy right here really thinks he's the man. He always likes to puff up and makes lots of noise. They're so cute. These here now are just about ready for butcher. Turkeys are getting big too. Even these little guys are growing pretty good. Geese are getting really big. They're loud sometimes. When they hear something they don't like, they get quite loud. Maybe a week and a half ago, 2 weeks ago, I put the ducks in with the geese, and they kind of like to stay back there. They do come out once in a while, and the geese go in there and sleep with them, but when they come out, I had to give them their own little water bucket, because when they come out to go up to this water, the geese like to go up and hiss at them and bite at them, and they're not very nice. These guys get let out now because the garden is about done. Another reason I want to do this right now is we happen to be having a stretch of some 80 degree weather. We're in the middle of September now, so some of our nights are getting down to 46. And I want these guys to make the transition out there when we have a couple of warm days. I know that this is going to come up in comments, so I thought I would take care of it right now, what I feed the birds. The first week to 10 days, I buy this right here. This is just from the feed store. It's just a game bird starter. Works for chickens, the turkeys, everything. And this is medicated, though, so I give them like 7 to 10 days of medicated. After the medicated, I switch to a starter grower, which runs 20% protein. And when you're running them on the 20%, you can just physically like watch the birds grow from day to day sometimes. It's amazing. Then from this, I feed this probably 3 weeks, maybe four. And then I switch over to a grower finisher, which is 15%. And I just keep them on that for the whole time now until it's time for butcher. And I also will throw in, every couple days, I throw in some cracked corn, maybe a 20-ounce cup in with the quail and the little bunch of chickens and the bigger ones. I might give them, I don't know, you know, an ice cream pail full. Just dump it on the ground and they just love to eat it. All right, well, it's been a couple of weeks now since I put the quail, the little snowflakes, in with all the rest of the quail. As you can see, all the quail seem to be getting along now. You saw how brutal it was in the beginning, and two of the quail did die. But nothing you can do. You can't keep them, you know, one of them penned up all by itself. So that kind of stuff happens. The chickens and turkeys now, duck hunting is coming up this weekend here. I'll be gone for that. And then the next week I start to butcher these chickens. I'm only going to keep, I don't know, four, maybe six of the hens to add to my laying flock. Otherwise, all the rest are going to get butchered in its time. And then when that gets done, the turkeys will have their own pen because I'm going to keep them over the winter. I think I have three hens and I need to get a male in here so when they do start laying eggs in the spring, I can hatch those also. These little guys over here, the second hatch, the hatch that you saw this time, these I call them half highs, they're getting there. And it won't be that much longer, another, I don't know, a month, and these will be in the freezer also. The geese here, the ones that we bought now, well, like I said, I don't know if I said it before, but we're going to winter these. And then in the spring, hopefully they'll lay some eggs, and I hope I have males and females in there. And we'll incubate those and hatch them, and then we can finally get some geese in the freezer. And the ducks, they're camped out in the back there. I think I might have three females there too, and I'll have to get a male because I really would like to winter those also, collect the eggs in the spring, and hatch them. Okay, everyone, well, thanks a lot for watching. This is kind of a long video, but it shows you everything you need to know pretty much from start to finish. We'll see you guys on the next video.